Ladies and gentlemen, James Dean. Hi, Jimmy.
Hi, Gig.
We asked Jimmy over today because he's a racing man himself. A real one, not a crazy one. Incidentally, I think I should explain that Jimmy just stepped over from the set of Giants. And need I add, he plays a Texan. Speaking of racing, have you ever been in a drag race?
Well, are you kidding me?
I just thought I'd ask. No, Jim races in the tradition, you might say. Real racing cars, real tracks. How fast will your car go?
Oh, 900 miles an hour. Clock, it's run about 106, 7.
You've won a few races, haven't you?
Oh, one or two.
Where?
Well, I was sure pretty good at Palm Springs. I ran a Bakersfield.
Jimmy, we probably have a great many young people watching our show tonight, and for their benefit, I'd like your opinion about fast driving on the highway. Do you think it's a good idea?
It's a good point. I used to fly around quite a bit, you know, took a lot of unnecessary chances on the highways. And I started racing, and now I drive on the highways, and I'm extra cautious. Because no one knows what they're doing half the time. You don't know what this guy is going to do with that one. On a track, there are a lot of men who spend a lot of time developing rules and ways of safety. And I find myself being very cautious on the highway. I don't have the urge to speed on the highway. People say racing is dangerous, but I'll take my chances on the track any day than on the highway. I think I'd better take off.
Oh, wait a minute, Jimmy. One more question. Do you have any special advice for the young people who drive?
Take it easy driving. The life you might save might be mine.
James Dean was only 24 years old when he died in a high-speed crash in 1955. His career was very short. It spanned only three films. And yet, after his death, his fame continued to grow, and he was elevated to legendary and finally cult status. James Dean left behind a legacy of teenage rebellion for an entire generation. But there are those who believe he left behind even more, a curse on the car he died in. Dean's love affair with speed and racing fit in perfectly with his real-life persona. He sought out danger and loved to walk the edge. A brilliant but troubled young man possessed by demons only he could see. He was fascinated, some say obsessed, with death and the macabre. He liked to tell people he slept in a coffin and cultivated a relationship with TV's first glamorous ghoul, Vampira, who claimed to be a witch and sparked Dean's temporary interest in witchcraft and the occult. He was also photographed in mock hangings. Dean spoke often of death, especially his own, and said he had premonitions of it.